Look at the third question. A gulab jamun contains sugar syrup up to about 30% of its volume. Find approximately how much syrup would be found in 45 gulab jamuns, each shaped like a cylinder with two hemispherical ends with length 5 cm and diameter 2.8 cm. Okay, so see that they are given the shape of the gulab jam like this, middle cylinder and two ends hemispheres. Okay, the total length of this is given as 5 cm and the diameter is given as 2.8 cm. So diameter is 2.8 means radius equal to 1.4 cm. So here radius 1.4 cm and here also 1.4 cm, isn't it? So what will be the height of the or length of the cylinder? That is 5 minus total length is 5. So 5 minus 1.4 plus 1.4, that is 5 minus 2.8, we will get 2.2 cm. Next, what we have to do means, first we must find out the volume of one gulab jam. Okay, so how many gulab jams are there? 45 gulab jams are there. So after getting the volume of one gulab jam, we must multiply by 45. We will get the volume of 45 gulab jams. That is equal to what they are given in the question. Volume of sugar syrup is equal to 30% of volume of 45 gulab jams. That is given. Okay. So, sugar syrups only, volume of sugar syrups only they ask you to find out. Okay. So, for finding the volume of sugar syrup, first we must find out volume of 45 gulab jams. That one's 30% is the sugar syrup's volume. Understood? So, first we must find out volume of one gulab jam. Okay. So, write volume of one gulab jam is equal to volume of one gulab jam is equal to volume of cylinder plus volume of two hemispheres, isn't it? Right, volume of cylinder plus volume of two hemispheres. So, we know the value of cylinder measurement as well as the hemispheres measurement and the formula. Volume of cylinder is pi r square h plus two volumes of hemispheres are there. So, 2 into volume of hemisphere is 2 by 3 pi r cube, because only r value is needed for the value of finding the volume of hemisphere. So, in terms of pi, you can write that common factor pi r square. Here r and r must be same. So what is, if we are considering the common factor, we can take pi r square as a common factor into, this r also same as capital R only. Okay. So pi r square from this I have taken. What is the balance here? H. Plus pi r square I have taken. So 2 2s are 4 by 3. Then what is there? R is there. Isn't it? So pi r square. R is, pi value is 22 by 7. R value 1.4 into. So 1.4 we can write 14 by 10. Into 14 by 10 into what is our h value? Height of that cylinder only. What is the height of the cylinder? 2.2. 2.2 plus 4 by 3 into r 1.4. So we will get 7 and this cancel 2 times, 22 into 2 into 14 divided by 10 into 10 into 2.2 plus 4/3 × 1.4. All of you take your pencil and do the calculations. So see here, 22 × 2 × 14. That is 22 × 28 divided by 10 × 10 × 2.2 + 5.6 / 3. Take LCM here, you will get 22 × 28 / 10 × 10 × 12.2 / 3. If you are multiplying the numerators, you will get 75152 divided by 3 × 10 × 10. This much centimeter cube. This is the volume of one gulab jam. Okay. So what we have to find out? Volume of 45 gulab jam we have to find out. So volume of sugar syrup is equal to 30% of volume of 45 gulab jams. Okay. So volume of 45 gulab jams is equal to 45 × this we will get 45 gulab jams, 45 × 75152 divided by 3 × 10 × 10. Three into ten in the denominators. Okay, so this much so see that 7515.2 / 3 × 10 × 10. So volume of 45 gulab jams equal to 45 × this value. So 7515.2, I am writing that as 75152 / 10. So the denominators already 2 tens are there. Again, this one decimal also I converted. So you will get 3 tens are there in the denominator. So volume of sugar syrup, next we have to find out volume of sugar syrup equal to 30% of volume of 45 gulab jam, isn't it? That is 30% 30/100 × 45 × this value 75152 / 3 × 10 × 10 × 10, that is 1000. 10 × 10 × 10. So after calculation and simplification, only 10, this 0 we can cancel, this 3 and this 3 get cancelled. So denominators are multiples of 10. It is very easy for after multiplication putting decimal is very easy for you. Okay, so 45 × 75152, you have to multiply it. You will get 3381840. After multiplication, 3381840 you will get divided by 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 followed by 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. So after counting the 4 digit, you have to put the decimal 1, 2, 3, 4. So 338.1840. Here the values are given in centimeter, so that much centimeter cube. So if you are writing this as approximately means 338 cm³, within bracket you write approximately. This will be the volume of sugar syrup. Question number 4, homework. Look at the 5th question. A vessel is in the form of an inverted cone Its height is 8 cm and the radius of its top, which is open, is 5 cm. It is filled with water up to the brim. When lead shots, each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5 cm are dropped into the vessel, 1/4 of the water flows out. Find the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. So I will draw the shape of this one. A conical shape. They are given that height is 8 cm. So the height they are given as 8 cm. And the radius of its top, which is open, is 5 cm. So radius they are given as 5 cm. R is given as 5 cm. H is given as 8 cm. It is filled with water up to the brim when lead shots, each of which is a sphere of radius. So we will have two shapes, a cone and a sphere shape. Lead shots is in the shape of a sphere, isn't it? So we will have two shapes. What are the two shapes here? Cone as well as sphere. Lead shots. Okay. Lead shots is in the shape of a sphere. So, what is the height of the cone? H is equal to 8 cm and R equal to 5 cm. This I have to consider the H and R as the radius and cone, height and radius of the cone. Next one, lead shot. What is the radius? I am considering this as R1. Okay. So, R1 lead shots the radius is given as 0.5. That is what? 5 by 10 centimeter. This is our R. Using this value only, we have to find out the number of lead shots. For finding the number of lead shots, if we are putting the lead shots in the vessel, 1/4 of the water flows out. Okay. So, volume of lead shots is equal to volume of water flows out. How much volume is flows out? 1/4 of the volume is flows out. Isn't it? So, number of lead shots is equal to, how will you write number of lead shots? Volume of water flows out divided by volume of one lead shot. Okay? So, write volume. They ask you to find out number of lead shots. So, separately doing and substituting, instead of that we can directly do the sum in the simplest method. Okay, that I will teach you. Here you people, some are going for tuitions and all, they will ask you to do fourth separately, then you have to divide it. Instead of that, within one step we can complete that. Therefore, number of lead shots is equal to, the formula is volume of water flows out divided by volume of water flows out divided by number of lead shots. Volume of water flows out means how much volume is flows out? 1/4 of the volume of the cone, isn't it? Because it is in the shape of a cone, so we will have 1 by 3 pi r square h is the volume of a cone. In that, 1/4 of the volume flows out. So we will get the formula as the numerator, 1/4 of the volume of cone, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h divided by number of lead shots. It is in the shape of a sphere. So, what is the volume of sphere formula? 4 by 3 pi r cube. So, pi and pi get cancelled. Here, r1 cube I am writing. Why? Because the radius of the sphere, that is the lead shot, is different. Okay. So, 4 by 3. So see the calculation. One by four into one by three into r square. What is our r value? Radius of the cone 5. So 5 into 8 divided by 4 by 3. Pi and pi already cancel. R1 is 0.5 centimeter. That is 5 by 10, isn't it? So P by Q format. So we have to do that. This first term, numerator, division changes to multiplication. Write the reciprocal of the second numbers. We can do the calculation like that. So we will get 1 by 4 into 1 by 3 into 5 into 5 into 8 into 4 by 3 become 3 by 4 into 10 by 5 into 10 by 5 into 10 by 5. Why? Because we are taking the reciprocals. Okay, then common terms you can cancel. 4 and 8 we can cancel 2 times. Okay, 1 5 1 5, another 5 here, also 5, this 3, this 2 we can cancel. This, okay, 2 2s are 4, again this 2 5, again this 5 and this 5 get cancelled. So only balance is the numerator, 10 into 10. So 10 tens are 100 lead shots. So how many lead shots are the 100 lead shots. Okay, so you can find out these volumes of the cone as well as volume of the sphere separately, and you can divide it and find out the value. Instead of that, I directly apply the formula and did it. Okay, so number of lead shots, what is the formula? Volume of water overflows divided by volume of one lead shots. This is very easy to get the answer in within 2 or 3 steps. Okay.